There are some very notable NFL players that have played for teams later in their careers that have really blown my mind, and I'm sure will blow yours, like Terrell Owens being a Seahawk and Joe Montana a Chief. So today I'm going to be going through 10 NFL players that you never knew were on these teams. Number 10, Ed Reed, Houston Texans and New York Jets. In 2013, after spending his entire Hall of Fame career in Baltimore, Ed Reed signed a 3-year contract worth $15 million with the Houston Texans. But just a few games in, he lost his starting job to Shiloh Keough, and on November 12, 2013, Reed was released by the Texans after limited production in his first 7 games. Ed Reed then signed with the New York Jets and managed 3 interceptions in the following rest of the season. Reed retired the following offseason as arguably the greatest safety in NFL history. Number 9, Chad Ochocinco, New England Patriots in 2011. On July 28th, the New England Patriots acquired Johnson in a trade with the Cincinnati Bengals. The Patriots traded 2 draft picks for Chad Johnson, and after 10 seasons in the NFL, he didn't have much left and recorded only 15 receptions for 270 yards. The following offseason, Ocho signed with the Dolphins, but was quickly released after he was arrested on a domestic battery charge. Number 8, Sean Alexander, Washington Redskins in 2008. The record-setting 2005 MVP running back for Seattle went downhill fast after his MVP season, and just 2.5 years later, the Seahawks released Alexander. He signed with the Washington Redskins, but was cut mid-season after only rushing for 24 yards in his final 4 games for Washington in 2008. Number 7, James Harrison, Cincinnati Bengals. In 2013, Harrison signed with the Cincinnati Bengals after being cut by the Steelers in 2013. He recorded 30 total tackles, 2 sacks, and an interception in his limited time with the Bengals. And on March 13, 2014, he was released by the team and then retired as a member of the Steelers, but came out of retirement to enjoy another stint with the Steelers and then the Patriots. 6. Wide receiver Andre Johnson, Indianapolis Colts. In 2015, the Colts signed Andre to a 3-year, $21 million contract. 34-year-old Johnson began the 2015 season as the NFL's active leader in receiving yards. He remained so until passed by Steve Smith in Week 4. The best game of Johnson's 2015 season came against his former team, the Houston Texans, where he caught 6 passes for 77 yards and 2 touchdowns. Johnson was released on March 9, 2016. In his only season with the Colts, Johnson made 41 receptions for 503 yards and 4 touchdowns, which at 34 isn't bad at all. Before we head into the top 5, make sure to smash that like button and subscribe if you've enjoyed the content thus far. Number 5, Randy Moss, Tennessee Titans. In 2010, Moss was claimed off waivers by the Titans after being cut by the Minnesota Vikings on November 3rd, 2010. Moss played 8 games for the Titans and started 4. He made 6 catches for 80 yards and no touchdowns. Moss then retired only to come back 2 years later to play for the 49ers, where he came just short of winning his first Super Bowl. 4. Darrelle Revis. After his second stint with the New York Jets, they announced that they would cut Revis at the start of free agency on March 9, 2017. Revis then signed a 2-year, $11 million contract with the Kansas City Chiefs. But after an injury-prone season on February 8, 2018, Revis was released by the Chiefs after playing only 6 games on the team. Revis then announced his retirement from the NFL after 11 seasons. 3. Emmitt Smith, Arizona Cardinals in 2004. Emmitt, despite being a Cowboys legend, actually topped off the Hall of Fame career with rushing for 1,000 yards at age 35 on the Arizona Cardinals before retiring, leading the NFL in all-time rushing list, ending his 14-year career on the Arizona Cardinals. 2. Steve Young. A quarterback winning 3 Super Bowls and 3 MVPs with the 49ers, Steve Young's career started a lot different than it turned out when he was drafted by the Buccaneers. The Bucs were in the midst of what would be 12 consecutive 10-loss seasons. They posted identical 2-14 records in Young's 2 seasons with them, going 3-16 with him as the starter. Young threw 11 touchdowns with 21 interceptions while completing fewer than 55% of his passes, but his career turned out a lot better than it started, and he is now regarded as one of the greatest quarterbacks in NFL history. Number 1, Jerry Rice, Seattle Seahawks. In 2004, age 42, Jerry Rice ended his GOAT career in Seattle when he was traded from the Raiders for practically nothing, where he caught 30 passes for almost 500 yards. Who else landed on teams that everybody forgot about? Let me know in the comments, subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next upload. Until next time.